वेलकम टू ई लेक्चर सीरीज फॉर बीटेक 6M सब्जेक्ट आर्टिफिशियल इंटेलिजेंस। माई सेल्फ प्रकाश मीना, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर कंप्यूटर साइंस एंड इंजीनियरिंग, इंजीनियरिंग कॉलेज अजमेर। एंड वी हैव ऑलरेडी डन टू टॉपिक्स इन डिफरेंट इश्यूज इन्वॉल्व इन NLP। सो नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इज इंफॉर्मेशन रिट्राइवल। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट विथ इंफॉर्मेशन रिट्राइवल। Information retrieval is the task of finding documents that are relevant to a user's need for information. The best known example of information retrieval system are search engines on the World Wide Web. So, as all of you know about World Wide Web, so how it works, we will see. A web user can type a query such as just like a AI book or any other into a search engine and see a list of relevant pages. So here we consider example as AI book. Then an information retrieval IR in short system can be characterized by first a corpus of document. Each system must decide what it wants to treat as a document, a paragraph, a page, or a multi-page text. Then second, queries post in a query language. So a query specifies what the user wants to know, and query language can be just a list of words such as AI book, or it can specify a phrase of words that must be adjacent. Sorry. And as in AI book, it can contains Boolean operations as in AI and book. And it can include non-Boolean operations such as AI near book or AI book site www.aaai.org. Then third, a result set. This is the subset of document that the IR system judges to be relevant to the query. By relevant, we mean likely to be of use to the person who posed the query. For the particular information need expressed in the query, and a presentation of the result set. This can be as simple as ranked list of ranked list of document titles, or as complex as a rotating color map of the result set projected onto a three-dimensional space and rendered as a two-dimensional display. And in earlier IR system work as a Boolean keyword model. Each model in the document collection is treated as a Boolean feature that is true of a document if the word occurs in the document and false if it is not. So the query language is the language of Boolean expression. So query language is the Boolean expressions over features. A document is relevant only if the expression evolution to true. This model has the advantage of being simple to explain and implement, and however it has some disadvantage. First, the degree of relevance of a document is a single bit, so there is no guidance as to how to order the relevant documents for presentation. Second, Boolean expressions are unfamiliar to users who are not programmers or logicians, and users find it unintuitive that when they want to know about farming in the states of just like Kansas. Here we use the example from the book. So in the state of Kansas and Nebraska, they need to issue the query. And third, it can be hard to formulate an appropriate query even for a skilled user. Then next is IR scoring function. So most of IR system have abandoned the Boolean model earlier used and use model based on the statistics of word counts. So BM25 scoring function, which comes from the Occupy project of Stephen Robertson and Karen Spark Jones at London City College, and has been used in search engines such as the open source Lucene project. and a scoring function takes a document and query and return say numeric score. The most relevant documents have the highest score, and in the BM 25 function the score is a linear weighted combination of scores for each of the words that make up the query, and three factors affect the weight of a query term. First, the frequency with which a query term appears in a document, also known as TF for term frequency, and for the query just like farming in Kansas, the document that mentions farming frequently will have higher scores. Second, the inverse document frequency of the term or IDF in short. So the word in appears in almost every document, so it has a high document frequency and thus a low inverse document frequency, and thus it is not as important to the query as farming or Kansas. And third, the length of the document. A million word document will probably mentions all the query words but may not actually be about the query, and a short document that mentions all the word is a much better candidate. Then it would be impractical to apply the BM25 scoring function to every document in the corpus. Instead, systems creates an index ahead of the time that lists for each vocabulary words the documents that contain the word, and this is called the hit list for the word. Then when given a query, we intersect the hit list of the query words and only score the documents in the intersection. And then next is IR system evolution. So here you can see a table also, relevant and non-relevant, and result set and not in result set. So how there is a question, how do we know about whether IR system is performing well? So we undertake an experiment in which the system is given a set of queries, and the result sets are scored with respect to human relevance judgments. So there has been two measures used in the scoring. So here recall and precision. So here an example, imagine that an IR has returned a result set for a single query for which we know which documents are and are not relevant out of a corpus of 100 documents. So the document counts in each category are given in table here, you can see here. Then precision measures the proportion of document in the result set that are actually relevant, and in our examples, like the precision is 30 divided by 30 plus 10 is equal to 0.75. So the false positive rate is 1 minus 0.75 is equal to 0.25. And then recall measures the portion of all the relevant documents in the collection that are in the result sets. And so example, 30 divided by 30 plus 20 is equal to 0.60. The false negative rate is 1 minus 0.60 is equal to 0.40. So in a very large document collection such as World Wide Web, recalls is difficult to compute, and because there is no easy way to examine every page on the web for relevance, all we can do is either estimate recall by sampling or ignore recall completely and just judge precision. In the case of a web search engine, there may be thousands of documents in the result set, so it makes more sense to measure precision for several different sizes, such as p@10 precision in the top 10 results, or p@50 rather than to estimate precision in the entire result set. And it is possible to trade precision against recall by varying the size of the result set returned. So in the extreme, a system that returns every document in the document or collection is guaranteed a recall of 100% but will have low precision, and alternatively a system could return a single document and have low recall but a decent chance at 100% precision, and a summary of both measures is the F1 score, a single number that is the harmonic mean of precision and recall. So there is a 2PR divided by P plus R. Then our last third one. Okay, so 1 minute, sorry for disturbance. Okay, back to our topic. Sorry for time. Okay, so next is IR evolution. So there is a next is IR refinement. So there are many possible refinements to the system, and indeed wave search engines are continually updating their algorithm as they discover new approach and as the wave grows and changes. So one common refinement is better model of the effect of document's length on relevance, and there is a single observed that a scientist 1996 observed that simple document length normalization schemes tends to favor short documents 100 much and long documents next not enough, sorry, and they prepared a pivoted document length normalization scheme. The idea is that the pivot is the document length at which the old style normalization is correct, and documents shorter than that get a boost and longer ones get a penalty. So BM25 scoring function uses a word model that treats all words as completely independent, and but we know that some words are correlated, such as couch is closely related to both couches and sofa. So many IR systems attempt to account for these correlations, and for example here about couch, and if the query is couch, it would be same to exclude from the result set those documents that mentions couch or couches, but not couch. And most IR systems do case folding of couch to couch, and some uses a stemming algorithm to reduce couches to the stem from couch, both in the query and the documents. And this typically yields a small increase in recall, and however it can harm precision. So here example, stemming stocking to stock will tend to decrease precision for queries about either food covering or financial instrument, although it could improve recall for queries about warehousing. And stemming algorithm based on rules cannot avoid this problem, but algorithm based on dictionaries can. So while stemming has a small effect in English, it is more important in other languages also. So next step is to recognize synonyms like such as sofa for couch. As with stemming, this has the potential for small gains in recall and but can hurt precision. A user who gives the query wants to share results about the football player, not sofas, and the problem is that language abhor absolute synonyms, just as nature abhors a vacuum. and it is written by Cruz 1986. So that anytime there are two words that means the same things, speakers of the language conspire to evolve the meaning to remove the confusion, and related words that are not synonyms also play an important roles in ranking. So terms like leather, wooden or modern can serve to confirm that the document really is about couch, and synonyms and related words can be found in dictionaries by the or by looking for correlations in documents or in queries. If we find that many users who ask the query so new sofa like, follow it up with the query new couch, and we can in the future alter new couch new sofa to be new sofa or new couch. And as a final refinement, IR can be improved by considering metadata. So data outside of the text of the document, an example includes like human supplied keywords and publication data. On the web, hypertext links between documents are a crucial source of information. So here completed IR refinement. So next is PageRank algorithm. PageRank was one of the two original ideas that set Google search apart from other web search engines, and when it was introduced in 1997, text so and PageRank was invented to solve the problem of the tyranny of TF tyranny of TF scores. And if the query is just like IBM, so how do we make sure that IBM's homepage IBM.com is the first results, even if another page mentioned the term IBM more frequently? So the idea is that IBM.com has many in links, and just like link to the page, so it should be ranked higher, and each in link is a vote for the quality of linked to page. And but if we only counted in links, then it would be possible for a web spammer to create a network of pages and have them of point to a page of his choosing and increasing the score of that page. So therefore so the PageRank algorithm is designed to weight links from higher quality sites more heavily. So again there is a question, what is a high quality site? So one that is linked to by other high quality sites. The definition is recursive, but we will see that the recursion bottom out properly. So here is a page rank for a page. P is defined as so you can see here a equation PR, P is equal to 1 minus D divided by N plus D summation, then PR in I divided by C in I. So where PR, P is the page rank of pages P, and N is the total number of pages in the corpus, and in I are the pages that link into P, and C in I is the count of the total number of outlinks on the page in I. So the constant D is a damping factor, and it can be understood through the random surfer model. So imagine a web surfer who start at some random page and begin exploring. So with probability D, the surfer clicks on the one of the links on the page with probability 1 minus D, he gets bored with the page and restarts on a random page anywhere on the web. So the page rank of page P is then the probability that the random surfer will be at page P at any point in time, and page rank can be computed by an iterative procedure and start with all pages having PR P is equal to 1 and iterate the algorithm and updating ranks until they converge. Okay, then the HITS algorithm, hyperlink introduced topic search algorithms. and also known as Hubs and Authorities or HITS, is another influential link analysis algorithm. And HITS differ from PageRank in several ways. So first, it is a query dependent measure. It rates pages with respect to a query, and that means that it must be computed anew for each query. And here you can see HITS algorithm for computing hubs and authorities with respect to a query. So that means it must be computed one anew for each query, and computational bunches computational burden that most search engines have elected not to be take on. And given a query, HITS finds a set of pages that are relevant to the query. It does that by increasing hit list of query words and then adding pages in the link neighborhood of these pages. And pages that linked to or are linked from one of the pages in the original relevant set. So in HITS algorithm, each page in this set is considered an authority on the query to the degree that other pages in the relevant sets points to it. A page is considered a hub to the degree that it points to other authoritative pages in the relevant set. And just like as with page rank, we don't want to merely count the number of links. We want to give more value to high quality hubs and authorities. Thus, we as with page rank, we iterate a process that updates the authority score of a page to be the sum of the hub scores of the pages that points to it, and the hub score to be the sum of the authority scores of the pages it points to. So if we then normalize the score and repeat k times, the process will converge. So both PageRank and HITS played important roles in developing our understanding of web information retrieval, and these algorithms and their extensions are used in ranking billions of queries daily as search engines steadily develops better ways of extracting finer signals of search relevance. And here our last topic, question answering. So information retrieval is the task of finding the document that are relevant to a query, as we know, and where the query may be a question or just a topic area or concepts. So here is a new question answering is a somewhat different task in which the query really is a question, and the answer is not a ranked list of document but rather a short response, just like a sentence or even just a phrase. There have been question answering NLP, natural language processing system, since the 1960s, but only since 2001 have such systems used web information retrieval to radically increase their breadth of converts. And there is a system Ask Mars, or you can say ASKMSR. So Ask MSR system developed by Benko in 2002 is a typical web-based question answering system. It is built on the intuition that most questions will be answered from many times on the web. So question answering should be thought of as a problem in precision, not recall, and we don't have to deal with all the different ways that an answer might be phrased. So we only have to find one of them. Also, once the n-gram are scored, they are filtered by expected types. So if the original query start with who, so for example, so then we filter a name of people. So here I mention something about this. For answer question answering, you will get the information or example for more about Ask MSR. For a simple example, just like who killed Abraham Lincoln, so you can go there and check that example. So we start with our query. If the original query starts with who, then we filter on names of people, or for how many we filter to numbers, and for when on a date or time There is also a filter that says the answer should not be part of the question together. This should allows us to return John Wilkes Booth and as the highest scoring response. So there is also related to Abraham Lincoln, so it may make the highest scoring response. In some cases the answer will be longer than three words. So since the component's responses only go up to 3 grams, a longer response would have to be pieced together from shorter pieces. And for example, in a system that used only bigrams, the answer John Wilkes Booth could be pieced together from high scoring pieces, and John Wilkes and Wilkes Booth in short. And at the tax retrieval evolution conference, just for TREC, Ask Me MSR was rated as one of the top system, beating out competitors with the ability to do far more complex language understanding. So Ask MSR relies upon the breadth of the content on the web rather than on the on its own depth of understanding. So it won't be able to handle complex inference patterns like associating who killed with or in ended the life of but it knows that the web is so vast that it can afford to ignore pages like that and wait for a simple passage it can handle. So here is all about information retrieval and their different techniques. So session ended here. Thank you.